Sir Ian, it's absolutely fantastic to be with you here tonight. Can you just start by telling us a bit about tonight's festivities and why it means so much to you?
Well, this theatre, the Parks Theatre in Finsbury Park, just by the tube station, has been open for 1 year. And we're celebrating that birthday. I'm celebrating because, although I haven't yet seen a play here, I've not been in the country, I was here when it was being built, and it was so exciting. Exciting that there was a local theatre in this part of London, and that its aim was to do as much new work as possible, and to provide as cheap prices as possible, and that it's done. It is amazing that there have been, I think, 25 shows here in the last year, and someone living locally, a young person, could come, and on Tuesday could get in for 12 quid. And if they come to the second Tuesday of each run, they can get in for pay what you can. That means practically free theatre in Finsbury. And it's only possible because of the people who work here and the people who support it. And the support doesn't come from the public purse. There's no subsidy from the Arts Council or the local authority. It all comes from companies who approve or individuals who approve. And that's why you have this amazing lineup of artists tonight who wanted to help. That's what we're doing here.
What do performers and an audience get from live theatre that they perhaps don't from film or television?
Well, you're in the company of the people that you're aiming to entertain, aren't you? And you can hear their response. There isn't an actor in the world who doesn't think that's somehow more exciting and more challenging than appearing on the screen. Of course, when you watch something on the screen, in a sense, it's dead, it's over, it's finished. They're just shadows on the screen. But in the theatre, no, we're there. It's happening for you. It's unique. It'll never happen again in quite the same way.
Of course, I mean, theatre's been such a massive part of your career, your life. For you, what's been your proudest and most electrifying moment on stage?
Well, I don't think I've got one, but every time I go out there, it's exciting and fulfilling. As we were saying, it's the live audience being there in their presence and being able to look in the eye of the people that you're hoping to entertain.
Are we going to see you back on stage again anytime soon?
I'm not going to see me on stage soon. After all I've said, I'm going to do stuff on the screen. I'll be back with Vicious, the sitcom with Derek Jacob, at the end of the year, and before that I'm going to make a movie, and I'm doing a radio play. But I've just finished a long run on Broadway with No Man's Land and Waiting for Godot, so my next theatre will have to wait for a bit.
Ben, it's absolutely fantastic to have you here with us tonight. What made you want to come and join this wonderful celebration?
The Bond couple. They're an amazing force for good. And I think the idea of creating a local theatre in a time of austerity and budget cutbacks and general funding crisis is a very bold and mad thing, but a brilliant thing and a vital thing. I think you can really genuinely take the temperature of a society and its health by how theatre is always thriving. And to have a theatre in this neck of the woods as well, and this kind of an intimate venue that has a pricing policy which means that it's accessible and not just a hope and a dream for artistic venture to thrive, is a remarkable achievement. And here we are a year later, garnering 5-star reviews for shows, some extraordinary performers and directors and writing that has happened in this on this stage behind me. And you know, to support it, and at its most crucial moment, I guess, it's established itself on the landscape, and now it's about continuing. And you think about great theatres like the Royal Court, that, you know, primarily obviously the Royal Court, it was all about new writing and new voices, and this theatre supports the same kind of enterprise. So it's fantastic in what is ostensibly my neck of the woods to have a local theatre that's doing the same, and all power to them. And it was a fantastic show as well, and there was quite a draw as far as who was on stage to entertain tonight. So, you know, that combined with a really worthy cause is why I'm here.
What do audiences and performers get from live theatre that they perhaps don't from other form of artistic expression?
The immediacy. You're in the room. You're part of the experience. You're not passive. You're in a group. There's a collective feeling to it. There's something that, I mean, imagine if you've never been to the theatre before and you see an extraordinary performance that makes you think either about your life or about life in general and the human condition or your locale or politics or even if it makes you actually forget all of that stuff, it just entertains you and distracts you from your circumstance. That's the power of theatre. And I think to have that experience immediately happening and playing out in front of you is sort of, it's unbeatable. There's nothing in the recorded arts that can quite compete with that. And that's why theatre will always have a place in society. I think also in the last few years, actually, especially with music, live music has really kind of come back, with a huge force. And again, that's because there's nothing quite like being in the presence of performers and of an event where the spoken word is shared. And it's a great thing, theatre. I mean, how can I not love it? I began in theatre, so I'm a little bit biased, but it has to keep on challenging itself to survive as well as challenging its audience. So it's the bedrock of great experimentation as well as revivals of established classics and familiar faces and established talent. It's also the place where people have their first breaks, whether it be directors, lighting designers, production designers, and artists in front of the curtain as well. So it's the lifeblood of culture, and I think it's a great sort of, as I said before, a great sort of temperature taker of a society's health. And there's nothing. Jez is trying to video bomb me. I wouldn't really call this a photo bomb.
Video bomb!
Can you believe that this immaturity is what resulted in this theatre? It's unbelievable. But no, seriously, I mean, it's a very important thing. I'm being serious here.
Okay, I'll go. I'll leave him.
I'm thrilled to be a part of it. And, theatre is really important to me, and I'm back on the stage in the next year, which is exciting, at the Barbican. And who knows, maybe one day here, I hope. But it's a fantastic venture, both for audiences and performers alike. So all power to it.
People like yourself and Tom Hiddleston, I mean, obviously it's an illustration of the importance of theatre that you both had that experience, and that's really where you learnt your craft.
Well, we both began in theatre. Tom, with Cheek by Jowl, and myself at Regent's Park, doing open-air Shakespeare and having absolutely no pre-judging kind of criteria of snobbishness about it. I, and as well as everyone else involved, treated it as if it was the RSC or the National. Why not? Because a paying audience was coming in to watch Shakespeare. Some of them maybe for the first time, some of them maybe seen that play umpteen times. So you have to work hard to justify why, the culture should be taking on a classic again. And Cheek by Jowl, in Tom's case, wonderful reinventings and reimaginings of classics. And, it's not just a debt of gratitude. It's done because as an artist you flourish, you thrive, you learn, you deepen your craft, and that can then apply to your work on the small screen. And there's every reason to have a close up on stage as there is to have something larger and theatrical in production on camera. So both things complement one another, and if you can bring a new audience to the medium of theatre through success on the small or large screen, then all the better. And I'm not just talking about stunt or star casting. I think it's important, like I said, to bring every aspect of every level of entry to the theatre to the fore. And Tom and I both began in theatre, so if we get our breaks there, hopefully other actors of the future will also have the chance to do that. And that can't happen unless places like this thrive and produce new work and opportunities for those performers. So That's really why I'm here. That's why I love theatre, and I still get a kick out of it as an audience member. I'm continually inspired, and there's nothing quite like being in the presence of a great, great, great live moment in theatre, because you only share it with another few hundred people as opposed to maybe a million watching it, and that's a very special thing. That's a very special communal and cathartic and inspiring and often hilarious and jovial as well as very serious. I'm sorry, very serious, like it's all about the good of society, but it's also just about having good fun. It's a great, great way of entertaining people as well. And I honestly think the kind of explosion in popularity of live music in the last few years is a marker of that as well as theatre. And obviously, we're going through interesting times with media as far as television and film are concerned, and how they're distributed, how they're exposed. And theatre remains the same thing. It's people in a building watching something for one night. And that's that's unique. That makes it absolutely unique. So I think both can learn off each other. I think film stage productions are a great idea as well, and they broaden access. But long may the art of live theatre continue, and I'll always come back to it, because as a performer, I mean, you know, look at Mckellen, who is here tonight, and the great, great actors of every generation. I was at Peter O'Toole's memorial this afternoon, and he was a great exemplar of somebody who profoundly began in theatre, and yet was the most extraordinary British screen icon, let alone actor of celluloid history, really. I mean, an incredible man, both on screen and on stage. So, and he came back. I remember seeing him first in Geoffrey Bernard's Unwell before I saw any of his films, before I saw God, Lawrence of Arabia, and all of his film work. That was how I first experienced him, was on the stage, and it was extraordinary. I mean, it was a part that was written for him, not about him, obviously, but for him by Keith Waterhouse. And I remember I was 17 or 16, it was a school outing, being absolutely transfixed and inspired to be part of what he was achieving, to learn from what he was doing. And I wanted to have a go. He was that good. I mean, you sit back and luxuriate in his brilliance, but at the same time, as an actor in the making, you kind of want to try some of it. And it's a wonderful thing. It's a really wonderful thing, and a very, very, very importantly British tradition as well. So, yeah.
What made you want to get involved and support this wonderful theatre?
It's a marvellous theatre. I used to be a milkman around here in 1980. I used to deliver milk in Charteris Road, Fonthill Road, Moray Road, Tollington Park, Stroud Green Road, Upper Tollington Park, Victoria Road, Alba Road. So I felt I owed it to the area to come back.
Can you tell us a bit about the sketch tonight? 40, 45?
What can I just say that Harry, I think, has bought up most of the surrounding properties. He's always been one with an eye for a bargain. Oh, yeah. Well done, Harry. Very good.
Well done,
he made me do it, and it's a sketch that we did about 6 or 7 years ago, when we've not done it since. But because we can't remember anything, we just say 40, 45. 40, 45. 40, 45. 40, 45. 40, 45. 40, 45. A lot.
For you guys, what's the magic of live performance? What do you get from that you don't from television and film?
Fear.
Fear, yeah. And shaking.
And no money, and it's for charity. No, we don't do a lot of live stuff, do we?
Really, no. I like Paul to do something good after all his Aviva adverts. Taking money off advertisers, I mean, please. The theatre, that's what it is, isn't it? The theatre, that's what life's about.
No comment.
Final question. Can we expect more theatre from you coming up, or is it back to Beaver Ad?
Oh, we love theatre, don't we?
Love the theatre.
Love the theatre.
Love the theatre.
I mean, we've been going to the theatre now for about 45 minutes. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good night.
Oh, and Aviva, if you want to change your artist, I'm free.
Anytime there is a theatre opening up, a small studio for actors to perform, to tell stories that people need or want to hear, you can call me to be part of that support, to be part of that. I like that. I got a call from Jez saying, would I come on down and celebrate the first year, a successful year of a new venue. I'm here. So yes, that's why I'm here.
And what's the magic of live theatre, both for an audience and for performers?
The immediacy of the communion. The immediacy for on stage to feel the vibrations of the audience, that you can take them through that story. For the audience to be experiencing something with strangers all around and be on a magic carpet to take them wherever that story takes them. That is not something that happens when you're sitting at home watching television or when you're sitting in a cinema. You know, I have a theory that, like a piano and a guitar, when the E on the piano is struck, the E string on the guitar will vibrate out of empathy. Actors are like those pianos. When we hit the truth of what's in that text, the audience can't help but to vibrate with it. And this is a magical thing, you know, and we're responsible for that. I love it.
And for you personally, have you got a particular memory of being captivated and electrified by a performance, either one you've given yourself or one you've been in an audience for?
Oh, many, many, many. To ask me to single one out would be cruel to all of the people that I've seen. I guess maybe the first one. I'm going off next week to do, or in 3 weeks to do Shakespeare in the Park. We're doing Lear, and I'm playing Gloucester in that. The last time I was in that park, I was about 14, 15 years old, when I saw Meryl Streep, David Ogden Stiers, and some other students from Juilliard doing Taming of the Shrew. I was bitten. That was it. I thought, that's what I want to do.
The Wire is often praised as one of the finest pieces of television ever. Do you think that's partly because it had that kind of theatricality, that sort of intimacy that we're used to seeing on stage more often than on small screens?
No, I think that it has more to do with the script, the story, the storytelling. David Simon's A Study of Society, 5 seasons being broken down into 5 very distinct categories. And I think that in the telling of that story, what he did was seek out theater actors to tell it. So he wasn't looking for film stars, you know. We were all pretty much unknown before The Wire. And that energy is what really served it. Also, as a theater actor, I think can work with civilians easier than someone who's never been on stage before. And so in The Wire, we had a lot of civilians working with us, the local people, the police, the drug addicts, you know, the neighbors in the neighborhood who had a story to tell. And David gave them a context within which to tell their stories. So we, as actors, have got to facilitate those stories coming out. That's something that comes from communicating on stage, because if someone screws up their lines on stage, that story still got to go on. You can't say, cut, we'll take that again. Yeah, so I think theater actors have a different training in communication and storytelling that served that piece very well.
It's fantastic to have you here tonight. Have you enjoyed tonight's festivities?
I've had an amazing time. It was mind-blowing, actually, the review. Totally funny, brilliant, brilliant performances. It was a really fitting celebration and an amazing turnout. And I really hope it raises lots of money. I mean, the theater's doing such brilliant stuff, but it can only help if it goes, you know, from strength to strength with that extra funding. I've been going to the theatre since I was really young. I feel really lucky to have done that, and I just feel there's just an innate thrill about being, it's so simple as an art form. It's, you know, just being in a room with other people collectively experiencing something, and there's a sort of pact you will make and a spell that can get cast, and it's sort of, I think it's something about all being changed simultaneously, collectively, as a community is a very addictive and exciting experience. I'm filming later this summer with Ian Mckellen, in fact, who is doing a film called A Slight Trick of the Mind about a very elderly Sherlock Holmes.
Where do you fit into that? Who are you playing in that?
I play a mysterious woman from his past who was involved in... Well, it's kind of hard to explain. It's a sort of a case from his past that haunts him. Yeah.
Well, so, I mean, Sir Ian hosting tonight, such a fantastic actor with an amazing legacy of stage and screen work. How excited were you to work with him, and how important is it to see faces like him supporting venues like this?
I'm so thrilled to be working with him. I mean, he's a very, very wonderful actor, wonderful man. And I think you can't really put a value on having the visual support of someone like Ian and all the people who are involved tonight on this theatre. I guess it just draws people attention to the building and the work that's being done here, and I guess gives it a glow and a sort of a status that people go, oh, well, if Ian McKellen's interested, then surely there must be something worth seeing here, and maybe they'll come in the door in a way they wouldn't have before. So, yeah, it's wonderful to have him here.
was curious how I came upon the Park Theatre, or Park Theatre. I was doing a documentary about memory called If Memory Serves Me Right, and one of the things they wanted me to do was to talk to actors about what they remembered before they were three. So out of the ethos, they chose a fundraiser for a particular theatre. So I came along and interviewed, rather like you're doing, people, Tom Stoppard, Tim Pigott-Smith, Josie Lawrence, about what their memories were before three, if any. And having met Jez, I said to him, well, you know, I've been directing Beverly in the Park, and Oliver Cotton, who's in it, has written a wonderful play. Would you be interested in looking at it? And he said yes. And then he said, I'll do it if you're in it. I hadn't thought of myself in that role, because it was quite a sort of, in a way, a bit more sort of sexy than I consider myself to be, but it's the best thing I've ever done. I did it here at this theatre for 8 weeks, and then on tour for 7 weeks, and we're about to take it into the West End for another 8 weeks, and I absolutely love it. So I loved being in Finsbury Park. You know, I love the Turkish hairdressing shops. I love the restaurants. I love the fruit shop at the Tube. Just love that I can park here in the evenings. And I like the layout of the theatre. I like the way it's sort of Donmar-like without being zhuzhy. And everything I've seen here has been of a very high quality. I think Melly and Jez have got very good taste. And it's a good place. It's open during the day. They're doing workshops for kids and for local people. And I want it to do well, but without an Arts Council grant, without subsidy, I mean, you know, you have to think of the money that goes to the big companies. And not just the money, but the best scripts first. And the 18-week rehearsal period. We get four. That's including Tech Week. So the wrong people are being subsidized. This is serving a very neglected community, and it's vibrant. It's, you know, it's very, very cosmopolitan, and it's lovely. So, you know, I'm very happy to support this place whenever I can, because it ain't enough to raise money for an interesting, fine building. You've got to run it. And that means, you know, paying people, paying staff, paying, you know, buying food, mending the leaks. We have to do that. We have to make sure this place survives.
Tonight is about celebrating Park Theatre's first year, about thanking all our supporters and giving everyone a fantastic evening. So we've had a number of wonderful high-profile stars from theatre. We've had Harry Enfield and Paul Whitehouse, Maureen Lipman, Ian McKellen hosting, Sean Mathias putting the whole thing together, Leslie Manville, the list goes on. It's been a wonderful 45 minutes on stage, or 45, as Harry Enfield said in his last sketch. It's incredible. The buzz is fantastic, and it's something I'm really thrilled about.
What do audiences and performers get from live theatre that they perhaps don't from other forms of like film and television?
Well, it's exemplified in the show we've seen tonight, this combination of great talent and intimacy. You get this buzz about a live theatre. It's a two-way relationship. It's not something that's on a screen that's pre-recorded. You're reacting live to the nuances of the actors, to the breath and the laughter and the crying of an audience. And that's something very, very powerful, particularly in our two intimate spaces.
For you personally, can you remember a moment or a particular performance that's really captivated you on stage, where you felt the magic of live theatre?
I think one of the shows I'm most proud of is Daytona, which has been on a national tour after we produced it here and is about to go into the West End. So that is an incredible achievement for us in our first year, and I want to be able to do more as we move forward.
What's coming up the rest of this year and beyond?
We've got a great show in at the moment called The Man Who Shot Liberty Valance, which is really exciting. It's so kind of odd and bizarre to do this Western on stage, but then you see it and it absolutely works. It's a lovely piece, and we've got a great season ahead and lots more to come. So check the website parktheatre.co.uk.
If people do want to get involved and support this theatre and others like it, where can they go for more information?
You can go to parktheatre.co.uk. It's very easy to support us. We don't have any public subsidy, so please give any donation, become a friend, come see shows and spread the word.